Greetings. Welcome to Tech Tuesday number 4. Now, last week I was talking about various reed muting systems for harmonicas, just going through the history of a whole bunch of different ones, which have been used since the 19th century. And today I want to talk on one of those systems that I've developed in a new way, I think. And I've taken out a USPTO provisional patent on it. The patent's got several aspects to it. It's called Magnetically Enhanced Reed Plate Slider Systems for Harmonicas. So that's the full title. Today, I just want to talk about one aspect of that provisional patent. Now, as I mentioned last week, the dominant note selection system these days is the front slider as used on chromatic harmonicas. And it works really well. But reed plate slider systems have got a lot of points to recommend them. For one thing, you don't have to have anything on the front of the harmonica. All the sliding action can happen inside the harmonica under the covers. That means your mouth can move closer to the reeds, which is always a good thing. Secondly, you can slim the harmonica down. I mean, if we're talking chromatic harmonicas, the comb is normally quite thick, and that's because you've got two reed plates separated by a horizontal partition in the middle, and your air shifts between the top and the bottom. With reed plate sliders, you can actually slim down the harmonica a lot because the note selection happens on the outside of the reed plates. So just to illustrate this comb thickness issue, here's one of my experimental harmonicas with the red comb, and here's a conventional chromatic. And you can see that the combs are quite different in thickness. But my one still does the same job. Conventional chromatic, my one. So it's still working as a chromatic harmonica, but it's got a comb half the thickness of the standard one. Thirdly, there's an intrinsic advantage with the reed plate slider. On a conventional chromatic, you've got two surfaces for the slider that have to be airtight. The top surface, the part that's facing you, and also the bottom surface, the part that's facing away. Both of them have to be really snug in their, against the surfaces they're rubbing against. And that's, quite tricky to maintain while you've got a slider in a kind of a moist environment with your saliva getting in there and keeping everything moving smoothly with just the right amount of tolerance so that it's really airtight but doesn't get jammed. I mean, that's quite tricky. Now, the advantage of the reed plate slider is that you've got, instead of having two surfaces that have to maintain a snug fit, you've only got one surface. So check this out. This is my overblow booster. Okay, so now you can see the slider itself. It's a reed plate slider. It's totally exposed. There's no need to get a snug fit on that because that's all happening in the cover plates, inside the harmonica, behind the cover plates. So that's an advantage. I mean, that's just basically one surface that needs to be really airtight instead of the conventional slider, which is two. In some cases with conventional sliders, the old-fashioned 270 type, you've got about six or seven different surfaces that have to be snug. But, on the modern chromatics, it's two surfaces. Well, as I said, reed plate sliders have been around since the 19th century. So what am I bringing to the party? What's new about my development of this old concept? Well, it's pretty kind of obvious as soon as I hold the harmonica up. You can see that the sliders are on the harmonica, they're moving, and they're doing their job, but they're not falling off anywhere. That's because I'm using magnetic attraction to hold the sliders in place. In this case, I've got base plates with tiny little magnets studded inside them, and with a slippery surface on top, that's a Teflon material, and then the slider itself is magnetically receptive, and it just grips onto the base plate with magnetic attraction. So I'm using reed plate sliders in two different ways. One is to switch between reeds, and another way is to selectively mute reeds. Now, this is my Overblow Booster Mark II, which I've recently released. This has got two sliders, one on the upper surface, and one on the lower surface, and that's because this harmonica is in Richter tuning. And the sliders are being used to selectively mute reeds. So you can see when I push the slider, it moves over the open reed slot below it and then closes it. And that means the air gets stopped or muted as I play. So if I blow into, you know, the harmonica, and what that does on this particular harmonica is it really enhances the overblows and overdraws. So if I do the same on the draw side, and that gives me really strong overdraws. And strong overblows as well. So in my provisional patent, I've covered lots of different variations on this idea. For instance, the base plates could be a solid magnetic material. They don't have to have magnets studded in them. Secondly, the slider itself could be a magnetic material and the base plate could be metal. So there's lots of different ways you could apply this idea. For example, in manufacturing, you might choose one way rather than another in order to lower costs. Personally, I'm working on quite a few different ways to use this idea because I think it's got a lot of really good aspects to it for the reasons I explained earlier. Slim combs, your mouth gets closer to the reeds, and it reduces the number of surfaces that have to be airtight. So in this video, I just really talked about the reed muting aspect in my Overblow Booster Mark II, which is working great. And hole number one overblow, number 10 overdraw, and everything in between. So it's really proving itself as a worthwhile and workable mechanism, which can be used in real harmonicas. And in next Tech Tuesday, I'll sort of look at a few other interesting developments using this same sort of idea, more for chromatic harmonicas, other kinds of harmonicas. So I'll see you then.